All right, so we're here with a world-renowned sprint car crew chief mechanic, distributor, kind of all-around guy for the sprint car industry, one of the leading crew chiefs and mechanics in the world, Scott Benic, Fairmount, Indiana. He's been on World of Outlaw Tour, USAC, complete history of all the upper-level series in the country, and he's got a bunch of new stuff going on this past year and upcoming. He recently joined forces with Craig Delansky and Destiny Motorsports, and I'd like to hear a little bit about the Destiny Motorsports deal, the history behind that. It's kind of a fairly new entity that a lot of people are kind of getting familiar with in the last 2 or 3 years. Seem like they really got going as far as competing in some of the upper echelons of racing, getting some name drivers in there, and then now a big change with joining forces with Craig, and kind of give us a rundown of Destiny and the behind the scenes of that and your involvement with that most recent and what's going on for 2015.
Well, Destiny Motorsports was formed probably 4 years ago, I guess, on a gentleman out of North Dakota and his wife, Rick and Barb Rogers. They put a little race team together, did some buyouts up in that area, and then just started racing up in that general area. And then for the 2012 season, I guess, they had contacted me about doing some Chili Bowl stuff, and which we did, and had a kid named Jamie Barnes drive one of our cars at Chili Bowl. From there, Jamie was going to Florida, so they asked me if I'd kind of tag along and make sure the motors was okay and all that stuff for down there, and it just kind of turned into a project to do from that point. We began that year, and then Jamie got committed to some of the things he had going on, so he couldn't come back and race quite as often as he wanted to. So we hired Brandon Wimmer to drive it, and so that worked out. We run most of 2012 like that, and then over the off season there, we picked up Jack Hodenshield to drive last year. Yep. And we did a lot of Kaiser wheel testing with Jack Hodenshield at the banks of Eldora and a lot of different places there, so it worked out.
He's a great R&D guy for any manufacturer.
Yeah, so that worked out well. I mean, we got to get familiar with changing halves and different things like that, and most of the time they held air. We won a race at KC one night, or at Atomic, or whatever they call it now, and the wheel, there's no way that it didn't shake, but I mean, it was, we took a 17-inch wide wheel and turned it into a 15, and it got stuck a little better and it worked pretty good, actually. So
that's good to hear.
So that's kind of where that went, and then by the end of the year, we were kind of wanting to get our motor program organized and get some things better, and our owner's goal was, since we started it, was probably a five-year program to put an Outlaw deal together. Some things came together with Craig to be able to do something a little quicker than that. So here we are at the beginning of the 2015 season with joined forces with Craig Delansky to drive the cars next year, the Destiny Motorsports cars on the Outlaw Trail. So
that's good to hear. We're always in search of new teams being added to the sport and people, getting in line to support what we have going on. Is the team going to operate out of your place up in northern Indiana? Or I know Craig's pretty hands-on as far as team operations. Is it going to be some up there, some down by you? What's the logistics going on?
No, the team's based at my shop in northern Indiana there. We run the day-to-day operations from there. The car owners, again, are from Williston, North Dakota. And Craig is going to come to us from Princeton, Minnesota. So, I mean, we've got a kind of a whole array of different locations on our group here, but the main race team itself is functioning out of northern Indiana there at our shop. So
okay. Myself being a mechanic in the industry, and watching you do what you've done for so many years, you've kind of been one of my heroes, or somebody definitely look up to and try to learn from, and you kind of are where you need to be as far as the top of your game and being on the business end of things, besides the physical wrench part of things, and you're definitely looked up to by a lot of people in the industry, other crew chiefs, mechanics, and you definitely have the resume to back that up with wins and championships. Of all the racing out there that you've enjoyed, wing, non-wing, midgets, you've done it all, and what's your most heartfelt form of racing that you truly enjoy the most? Are you a wing guy or are you a non-wing guy? What do you enjoy the most, and what's led to most of your success?
Well, I think, obviously I started as a wing guy, and then we came off the road in the late 90s to form a business and form a family with my wife and I. And then we started the non-wing thing. So, I mean, probably the greatest accomplishment we had is winning the USAC Sprint Car Championship, because that was my own project, my own funding. I found the money. I found the way to do that project. A kid named Levi Jones, which has obviously become kind of world-renowned at our sport here, kind of drove it and was a day-to-day fixture with our project during that time. But my true heart and soul has probably always been into wing sprint car stuff. It's just something I couldn't afford to financially put together. Right. The USAC thing was a little regionally better for us.
There's definitely a different financial aspect there.
So, I mean, it was a little regionally better for us. We didn't have to do as much traveling. It worked out very good for us to be able to do the USAC thing for the years that we had that going on. And, you know, my son's getting a little older now, the business is kind of in place. And there's probably enough time for me to go do what I'm trying to do again. Now, I had, we had won the USAC Silver Crown and the midgets and the sprint cars and the All-Star Championships and all the different stuff that we've won over the years. But something that's always eluded me was the Nationals and the Outlaw Championship. Maybe I'll retire with it still eluding me. I mean, it's hard to say, but I guess I'll never know if I don't go try. So,
yeah.
So those are a couple of the goals that I had left. And when we joined forces with these guys 3 years ago, going into our third season now, obviously that was kind of our goals, is to begin to look at things like that and see where we could get. Like I said, I don't think I'm nearly where I need to be yet, but I'm gaining on some things. The tire thing has gotten me a little fouled up on days, and there's a few things that I've not really been on top of as good as I need to be, but I'm working at it and getting better with it all the time. So
that's good. And you mentioned the Sprint Car Championship with USAC. That was important year for me. I was with TSR at the time, working on Jay Drake's car, and we were battling for points all year. And you guys prevailed, and that was awesome to be able to be in that battle with you guys right up to the very end.
Right.
It was right to the very end at Paris there, and it was pretty neat to be a part of that and have you next to us in the pits every week. And even though I'm here, I'm still watching the other guys and seeing right. what they're doing and trying to learn. And it's kind of led to your success and how successful you are. So appreciate you stopping by, Scott, and it's been an honor. And back to you guys.
Thank you very much.